sucks and I never tried. Mine's lost even more than I realized. Time's up, keep moving when she arrives. If you ever heard what I heard in my mind, never try, you would cry, that's a lie. You would... I don't want to ever come down from my... I am in a...
And here we go.
Checking out Utah's opening lineup. Conley and Mitchell, the talented backcourt pair. Ivanovic out there with Rudy Gobert. And it's O'Neal in at the small forward. Kept alive, Gobert. And sent back by Allen.
And let's see how it rise up and reject shooters. Just a juggernaut on defense.
Jefferson against Bogdanovich. Clock at four. Here's Gobert. And it's Gobert. Again, this is.
They had some nice coverage that turned into no coverage. Playing with high energy, outworking the defense up the floor. And I just love it when the fast break results in a high percentage look. Not always the case these days.
Here's Conley. After Chicago picking up a basket just moments ago. Pushing it up. Here's Richardson. A good finish at the rack off the stick feet.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering. It makes sense, right? You're trying to get off to a fast start, and he can help with that.
And the pass to Gobert. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
And there's a lot of talk about Gobert's rim protection, but his rebounding is every bit as important on the defensive end.
Yeah, that's finishing off defense. Once you force them to miss, you don't want to allow second-chance opportunities. Rudy Gobert averaged over 10 defensive boards a game last year. That was the best numbers of his career and top three in the league.
It's been a slow start here for Utah. It's a five-point game, and it's Allen Iverson with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. First quarter of play with about a minute and a half gone.
Good eyes by the defense. Clearly, that's not where he wanted the pass to go. And he's frustrated. Finding a little rhythm here that they have to like where they're at.
They're playing well. They're building momentum. This is how they can turn a small lead into a big one.
Now here's Gobert. Pass to Mitchell. And then Mitchell at the dunk.
And one of Gobert's advantages as a passer, he can see over everyone's head.
And a slam dunk by Richardson.
Only the one-hand tomahawk, guys. Somebody's going to get their feelings hurt.
Yeah, they got the entire bench up right there as they saw that out of their chairs. Now here's Conley. To the paint. And slam dunk by Gobert.
I mean, he's tailor-made for those pick-and-roll sets. Gobert, a big-time finisher on the move.
Richardson, good.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
And so it's Conley bringing up the ball for Utah. They trail by seven. Gobert with the pass to Conley. Gobert against Howard. Now, here's O'Neal. He started close. Rejected by Walker, and that one goes out of bounds. Nice touch by Walker. Chicago making some changes. JaVale McGee's checked in for Howard. Batum comes in for Walker. And it's John Morant in for Iverson. Joe Ingles is checked in for Utah. Clarkson comes in for Michael Conley.
a different look for Utah. Davis has checked in for Rudy Gobert. And Emmanuel Mudiay subbed in for Mitchell. And in this first quarter, about 3 minutes played, they get the rebound. And it's Davis finishing them off.
Just a terrific effort on the offensive glass. That's how they're going to cut into this league.
And Greg, a dunk like that is sure to give them a spot. Scooped up. Kicks it out to Richardson. Now, here's Morant for three. Here's Batum. Good. Nice assist from Morant.
And we're seeing some great ball movement out of this group, guys.
Utah trails by seven. And Batum throws it down.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
Turning defense into offense. Every coach talks about it. Perfect example right there.
So, it's Utah now. After Chicago picking up a basket just moments ago. Morant with the steal. And here we go. Fast break to Morant. And Jefferson throws it down.
Yeah, they have gone full throttle from the opening tip, showing no signs of letting up. Already ahead by double digits. Tried to run away and not look back.
Shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game. And the first one is Dwight Howard. He's checked in for JaVale McGee. So after making the first, he goes 1-for-2.
When you look back at that 2019 draft, Zion goes 1, Morant goes 2. And with everything we know about them now, could you imagine having to make that choice today?
That is a tough choice, GA. Or even crazier, could you imagine having both of them on your team? The reason why I say that, as amateurs, they played together in South Carolina. Little did they know at the time, they would be the future of this league.
And here's Mudiay, following John Morant's three. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down. And the thing that stood out for me last year about Mudiay, his shot selection was much improved.
It was, a fair high from the field. He was solid also from three. Still, he needs to clean up that turnover category. Remember, he is still very young, despite how long we've been talking about it.
3 seconds separate the shot clock and game. Got a piece of it. Bogdanovich passes to Davis. 5 to shoot. Ingles kicks to Mudiay. No good on the three. Batum with the three.
Credit to Ingles for how hard he plays. Taking the challenge defensively.
And so it's Chicago. Riding a 15-point lead at the end of the quarter. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And taking a look at Chicago's performance here, guys, well, what have they been doing or not doing?
Stingy on the defensive end in that first quarter. They were just getting up into people.
Yeah, they were very physical and very aggressive. They've just been the better team so far.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups. Courtesy of Peterick as the second quarter gets going. So for Chicago right now, Griffin is out there with Brian Russell. Then there's Victor Oladipo. Then there's Howard. And it's Marbury in at the one. Now here's Mudiay. T right on him. The dish to Bogdanovich. They get a hand on it and stolen by Howard. Russell with a wide open look. Trying for it. And Oladipo kicks for Russell. That's a nice ball movement here by Chicago. They get it again. Marbury passes to Russell. Good on the triple. Russell's got 8.
Coming off a scoreless first quarter, he's found a little rhythm here.
And so Clarkson will bring it up with Utah. Utah calls timeout.
Yeah, just looking to tighten up their defense in the paint. They've got to be better.
It's a matter of want to.
Helping out contesting shots, you have to want to make the effort.
So Utah going with an almost entirely new group. Rudy Gobert, he's checked in for Davis. O'Neal comes in for Bogdanovich. Donovan Mitchell's checked in for Jordan Clarkson. And it's Conley in for Emmanuel Mudiay. And here's the fast break. Russell leading the way. And it's Oladipo.
Just sheer determination. The contact was there, but Oladipo showing real toughness gutting through it.
Oh, challenging stretch here for Utah. On the wing, Mitchell. He'll get on the shot a bit long that time.
And that is the exact type of opportunity this offense is looking to create. You know, hit the ball to the right guy in the right spot. More often than not, you're coming away with points.
Conley against Iverson, knocks it loose, and stolen by Iverson. And again, Chicago running the court in transition. Here's Oladipo. Griffin dishes to Iverson. And the first timeout of the game called for Chicago. It's been several possessions since they've converted.
And they've got to find a way to change that.
Has to go there. Mitchell outside. Another miss by Utah. On deep. Oh, the lob to Valanciunas. It's stolen by Gobert. Chicago calls timeout. Started. Second quarter play with almost 3 minutes gone. Took him no time at all on that one.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic and is a big part of why they've been able to get these good and a wise move to call timeout there. They need to settle down a bit. They've been playing out of control at times here.
Chicago making some changes. Richard Jefferson, he's checked in for Griffin. Batum comes in for Russell. And it's John Morant in for Victor Oladipo. Conley, the shot's good on the assist by Engel.
You know, he's wiry strong. Conley's made a living taking contact and making shots.
And last season, at least at first, it was a challenge for Engel to mesh with Mike Conley.
I mean, Conley came in to run the offense, which kind of took the ball out of Ingles' hands a little bit. And then Conley goes out with the hamstring, and that allowed Ingles to get back into rhythm, and he's been able to handle that load many times for this group.
And the kicks to Mitchell. There's a minute 47 left in the second quarter. Back to Conley. Shot clock at 5. It's over Durant. Here's Gobert. That one dropped for his second bucket. Mark him 2 for 4.
He has a standing reach of 9'7". Gobert making that play look routine.
Here's Jefferson outside. A rebound by the Jazz. And now we've got the intentional foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
For the Jazz, Davis comes in for Joe Ingles as Jordan Clarkson in for Mike Conley. And here's Clarkson. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. And here comes the break. And it's Valanciunas finishing it off.
Look at the way Valanciunas ran the floor on that break. Very few centers can get up and down the floor like that.
Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this.
Focus, focus, focus. Just make the simple play.
Clarkson passes to Mitchell. Poked loose and stolen by Iverson for the finish. And the dunk by Iverson.
Yeah, you can't afford to let Iverson come up with the steal there. An opportunistic defender who knows what to go for.
Mitchell passes to Clarkson. Mitchell dishes to Gobert. That shot, no good. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. The tray. And there's Iverson. That's good on the assist from Batum. Iverson's got 9.
And just a great job of controlling that defensive backboard, then getting out in transition. That's been the difference.
Jefferson against Davis. Back to Mitchell. The Jazz shooting their sixth and seventh free throws in the game. Free throw shot for Mitchell.
He was a part of that terrific draft class in 2017. Donovan Mitchell was somewhat unheralded, but may turn out to be the best of the bunch.
Latoon passes to Marbury. Dishes it to McGee. From T. Iverson. And the last shot of the buzzer doesn't go in for him. And so it's Chicago. Second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. You got to like what Jason Richardson has done in this game.
Yeah, it's been a great performance from him, really staying focused on quality shots.
And many of those quality shots have been jumpers, a very high percentage of those in the first half.
Taking a look at the Jazz, Conley runs the point with Mitchell pointing him. Rudy Gobert is out there with Bogdanovich, and it's O'Neal in at the small forward position.
And Iverson constantly driving to the basket, using that speed and athleticism to kind of wheel his way to the rim.
Mitchell finds Conley. There's Gobert, and it's sent back by Howard.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
Richardson, good.
And still commanding a lot of defensive attention. Howard just keeps his head up and finds the open man.
Richardson's gone 75% from the field. Six baskets and eight attempts. And stolen by Iverson. He can't get that one to fall. Good work defensively by Conley. And there's the call on Howard. That'll be his second foul of the game. Victor Oladipo, he's checked in for Chicago. Conley, feeling it out, passes it to Mitchell. It's tipped, and the foul. And it looks like, yep, it's a coach's challenge on the personal foul. That triggers a replay review by the official.
This is the time now where the officials can review in closer detail what constituted the original personal foul. Getting a different angle can sometimes make it a lot easier to determine.
Greg, indeed, and the one thing with replay review is that when you see the slow motion replay, you really get a new appreciation for just the immense speed at which these players are moving and how fast the action really is and how hard it can be sometimes, you know, Greg, to make the right call. And so the word is in, they've decided that the call stands as it was made on the floor.
And you know, even if a coach still feels this wasn't the right call, you gotta acknowledge the effort being put in to review it. You're double checking and the game continues on. Always an explosive leaper. Oladipo's teammates can count on him to finish those alley-oops.
And stolen by Iverson. Fast break, here comes Chicago. Lobbed up there for Howard. Hammers the alley-oop through.
Howard still has more than enough left here to finish off plays like that.
And so Conley will bring the ball up for the Jazz. Searching for that first bucket here in the third. Kicks to Mitchell. And they get it. Oladipo with the block.
They have been more dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in cracking this huge lead.
Iverson passes to Oladipo. Good. That's Iverson who picks up the assist. Iverson's got his fifth assist in this one.
Adding to this lead, he's been dependable and consistent at the offensive end.
Back to Gobert. The Jazz with another miss.
What I like, he hasn't stopped competing despite the off night.
Offensive rebound. Howard dishes to Oladipo. Contend shot. And there's the nice layup by Griffin.
It's not hard to see why they are giving up points on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
Mitchell again. Rolled deep. And it's Mitchell missing.
All the energy is on the other side right now, and every miss just makes it worse.
You know what? This has always been a debate. Do you take the timeout, or do you let your guys try to fight through it?
And now they decide to foul intentionally. Chicago making a switch here. Richardson's checked in. Jazz also changing it up. Joe Ingles comes in for O'Neal, and it's Clarkson in for Mike Conley. Iverson against Clarkson. And stolen by Iverson. Here's Oladipo, and finished off by Oladipo.
Well, he gets great elevation for a player his size. Maybe we need to get Oladipo back in the dunk contest.
Oladipo's gotten 5 shots to fall in 8 attempts. Clarkson finds Gobert. 1:15 left in the third quarter. To end the cold streak, count it. Mitchell's got 6.
Donovan Mitchell, he covers every base, even showing the touch from mid-range.
Oladipo misses. Utah with the ball, and the foul is called. He intentionally grabbed him there for some reason. I don't know.
Kevin, all I can think of is that he's trying to slow the game down a little bit. That's a stretch, though. Definitely a strange move on his part.
Ed Davis is checked in for the Jazz. Manuel Moutier comes in for Donovan Mitchell. Stolen by Clarkson. And they go to the intentional foul. For Utah, they have made 7 out of 9 when they've stepped the ball on. The first free throw is good.
And still trying to find his footing in the league. Moutier must show improvement in his shooting moving forward.
And finished off by Oladipo.
And he gives that rim a good tug on the way down.
Well, that's how you drive your point home right there. Here's Moutier. He's got 6. And he lays it straight in. 8 points for him.
Huge hole in the defense that possession. He didn't waste any time cutting through.
Oladipo misses. And that's going to be too many steps. Gets the whistle on the travel.
And it's easy to give up after a play like that. But this team needs to keep fighting.
It's just one trip down the court. But you have to have short memory in this league or you won't last long.
1 second separate in the shot clock and game clock. Iverson pitch to Oladipo. Howard, the pass to Richardson. Here's Griffin. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Griffin's got 5 points in the quarter.
And they have been relentless from deep. And you see the defense trying to react, but to no avail.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime, and they're doing a better job of creating space.
And so is Chicago, holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter wraps up. But how about a look at today's State Farm assist of the game?
It's just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about that perfect delivery?
Execution. This is what you practice. These guys are professionals. Beautiful play.
And as we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same from the first 3 quarters. Victor Oladipo is out there with Moran. And there's JaVale McGee. Then it's Jefferson. And it's Griffin in a power forward. So that's the 5 in the game for Chicago. So he gets them both. Chicago with the ball. And Oladipo has it in the corner. Jefferson with the 3. And it's Bradley with the rebound. And he commits the intentional foul. Chicago making some changes. Walker comes in for Blake Griffin. And it's Richardson in for Jefferson. Now the pass to Tucker. It's stolen by Oladipo. Fires the 3. Richardson gets to Oladipo. A 3-pointer is right on target. Oladipo's got 12 points in just the second half.
I don't know what coach told him at halftime, but he is shooting the lights out right now.
and Utah turns it over again.
That's what happens when nothing goes your way. You start to lose focus, and it makes matters worse.
Howard's checked in for JaVale McGee. And here's Richardson outside. Good, and it's Oladipo picking up the assist.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
No one near Moutier as he lets it go. Poked away.
And all you got to do is look at the rebounding margin as to why they hold the lead.
Effort's been there. Check mark. The physicality. Check mark. They set the tone for this game early on.
And it's Moutier with the ball. He brings it up for the jam. And the foul on Victor Oladipo. That'll be his second foul of the game. Williams Cross is checked in for the Jazz. Moutier with the ball. Now defended by Oladipo. Looking to end the run. Tucker can't get it to go. They are enjoying a commanding lead.
And it really gives them the opportunity to get their starters a rest. Always critical when you get ready for that home stretch. And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Moutier against Morant. A floater, and it's laid in by Moutier.
Man, he keeps doing his part. They just haven't been able to get over the hump.
Here's Oladipo. He watches it go to the hoop for his eighth make. Now 8 for 14.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
To the right side. Morant against Moutier. To the inside. Morant with the steal. Here's Oladipo. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
And there's that scorer's mentality that Oladipo possesses, which really puts the defense in a bind trying to stop it.
Oladipo hits them both. Just over 2.5 minutes played now here in the final quarter of regulation. Moutier passed to Brandon. And Tucker picks to Moutier. And the rejection by Valanciunas.
Valanciunas, he's got that long wingspan. You saw it right there on that play.
And now Utah, pass break. Oh, and it looks like that's going to be a goaltending call. Yep, that's it. So they'll get the basket.
So close to getting the block there. You can live with those calls because you'd rather have a guy playing aggressive instead of playing safe. It just won't miss. I mean, this is incredible.
Good shooting can be contagious. You see the confidence running through this team right now.
There's the steal. And finished off by Oladipo.
What I like here, even with the big lead, they continue to execute their offense.
They've taken nothing for granted. You can see they're playing the moment rather than the score.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. 5 on the clock. Moutier pass to Brandon. Nice pass, nice catch, and a resounding dunk.
One of the cases where height fails to tell you the whole story.
Russell finds Valanciunas, takes the alley-oop pass, and it comes to town.
Getting off his feet quickly, Valanciunas on the receiving end.
1:19 left in the game. Here's Williams-Goss, and that one drops for him. Williams-Goss has got his first basket.
That's nice work, stopping short of the rim, just laying it over the top.
Here's Russell with a three, another three for Chicago.
Heavy incoming from beyond the arc, a key part of their initiative this entire fourth quarter.
Interesting approach coming down the stretch, looking to rack up points in chunks.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
And you know what? Very close to a three-point play right there.
First free throw is good. And Davis is here. No good on the second free throw.
They needed more from him there. Any point they can get is absolutely critical for them right now.
And it's just competing. And, you know, giving your best when it matters most.
It's called killer instinct. It's one thing to be close at the end. It's another to finish.
And Tucker kicks to Niang. Tipped away. Stolen by Walker. And now Oladipo pushing it up.
Oh, and I love it whenever Oladipo gets tricky with it. Putting on a show for everyone with that.
Is Russell with the drive.
He takes advantage of him in every way possible.
And Grady lures them into a trap on the steal, and then bang, straight to the bucket.
Great activity at both ends. Great teamwork as well.
Tucker, the pass to Williams-Goss. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for two. It's on Jonas Valanciunas.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
Both good from the line that time. It's stolen by Davis. And so they foul intentionally.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
And so he makes both from the line. Marbury passes to Russell. Here's Oladipo, and finished off by Oladipo.
Too smooth. Oladipo down the lane with such ease. His agility really gives him an edge.
And so Chicago takes this one and by